The First Jungle Book, Mowgli, written by Rudyard Kipling, narrated by Lucy Stone. Tiger, tiger, what of the hunting, hunter bold? Brother, the watch was long and cold. What of the quarry ye went to kill? Brother, he crops in the jungle still. Where is the power that made your pride? Brother, it ebbs from my flank and side. Where is the haste that ye hurry by? Brother, I go to my lair to die. Now we must go back to the first tale. When Mowgli left the wolf's cave after the fight with the pack at the council rock, he went down to the ploughed lands where the villagers lived, but he would not stop there because it was too near to the jungle, and he knew that he had made at least one bad enemy at the council, so he hurried on, keeping to the rough road that ran down the valley, and followed it at a steady jog trot for nearly 20 miles till he came to a country that he did not know. The valley opened out into a great plain dotted over with rocks and cut up by ravines. At one end stood a little village, and at the other the thick jungle came down in a sweep to the grazing grounds and stopped there as though it had been cut off with a hoe. All over the plain cattle and buffaloes were grazing, and when the little boys in charge of the herd saw Mowgli, they shouted and ran away. And the yellow pariah dogs that hang about every Indian village barked. Mowgli walked on, for he was feeling hungry, and when he came to the village gate, he saw the big thorn bush that was drawn up before the gate at twilight pushed to one side. "Mph," he said, for he had come across more than one such barricade in his night rambles after things to eat. "So men are afraid of the people of the jungle here also." He sat down by the gate, and when a man came out he stood up, opened his mouth and pointed down it to show that he wanted food. The man stared and ran back up the one street of the village shouting for the priest, who was a big fat man dressed in white, with a red and yellow mark on his forehead. The priest came to the gate, and with him at least 100 people, who stared and talked and shouted, and pointed at Mowgli. "They have no manners, these menfolk," said Mowgli to himself. "Only the grey ape would behave as they do." So he threw back his long hair and frowned at the crowd. "What is there to be afraid of?" said the priest. "Look at the marks on his arms and legs. They are the bites of wolves. He is but a wolf-child run away from the jungle." Of course, in playing together, the cubs had often nipped Mowgli harder than they intended, and there were white scars all over his arms and legs. But he would have been the last person in the world to call these bites, for he knew what real biting meant. "Ah, ah," said 2 or 3 women together. "To be bitten by wolves, poor child. He is a handsome boy. He has eyes like red fire. By my honour, Messua, he is not unlike thy boy that was taken by the tigers." "Let me look," said a woman with heavy copper rings on her wrists and ankles, and she peered at Mowgli under the palm of her hand. "Indeed, he is not. He is thinner, but he has the very look of my boy." The priest was a clever man, and he knew that Messua was wife to the richest villager in the place. So he looked up at the sky for a minute and said solemnly, "What the jungle has taken, the jungle has restored. Take the boy into thy house, my sister, and forget not to honour the priest who sees so far into the lives of men." "By the bull that bought me," said Mowgli to himself, "but all this talking is like another looking over by the pack. Well, if I am a man I must become." The crowd parted as the woman beckoned Mowgli to her hut, where there was a red lacquered bedstead, a great carthen grain chest with funny raised patterns on it, 6 copper cooking pots, an image of a Hindu god in a little alcove, and on the wall a real looking glass, such as they sell at the country fairs. She gave him a long drink of milk. Mowgli was uneasy, because he had never been under a roof before. But as he looked at the fat...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.